Hey everybody, this is NJP Sims on Rick 73 Test 1 on where else but the Google Tube. Anyway, a lot of you guys are probably going to recognize this building as being one that we tried to move a family into the other night on the live stream, and I failed quite spectacularly with this because for one reason or another, I could not put furniture. Let's drop the walls down here. I could not put furniture in the upstairs of the living unit, and I was completely baffled by this, and for some reason, you know, I came to the conclusion that you couldn't use a two-story apartment building, you know, have one apartment on two floors. But I did a little checking on this, and I found out I was wrong about this. You can actually do that. The problem I have is in the type of stairs that I used. See, I've got a landing and stairs that go up like this. Unfortunately, yeah, I can't pick it up, of course not. But unfortunately, these are considered as outside steps. Now, in an ordinary house, they work perfectly fine inside. There's no problem whatsoever. But in an apartment setting, they don't work because this is considered as an outside object. So therefore, the first floor is fine. You can do whatever you want. But the second floor is inaccessible because it's considered as an outside area. And in apartment life, you can't build in the outside area when you're actually in the gameplay mode. So, what do I need to do to fix that failure? As you can see, a lot of this stuff is grayed out on here, and I can't use it. So what I need to do is change my lot zoning, and of course, you use the cheat enter thing here. And some of you guys may know about this, some may not, but you type in change, Z-O-N-I-N-G, change lot zoning space, and make it, I can't talk and type at the same time, but change lot zoning residential, you hit enter. And now they didn't change right away. In order to make that work, what you have to do is you have to leave the lot and then come back, and then you'll be able to have the full architectural editing things in there. So we go back to the neighborhood, save, and then come back to it. Okay, and I spared you the agony of having to sit through the seemingly endless loading screens, but you'll notice now when we go into the build mode that all the items are now available because I changed the lot zoning to a residential from apartment base. And when I get done doing my modifications on here, I'll change it back, and then I'll take a test family, move them in there, and just see if this actually does work. And I will do that in front of you guys because I can, I suppose. But what I need to do is I want to figure out exactly how I want to work that stairway. So I'm not going to be able to use it the way that it was. So first thing I'm going to do is take the old sledgehammer and eliminate those stairs. Goodbye, and sad to see you go. Oh, what did I... I took the floors out and left the... Oh, because I have to go to the foundation tool and do it this way. Or maybe not. I think I screwed the pooch on this one. Let me try it this way now. It won't let me... Oh, because there's a handrail there, of course. Let's get rid of the handrail. Let's get rid of the handrail. Come on, cooperate with me. Please, like the cooperators. And let's see. Can I get in there to do this and different things? There we go. Whoops. There. Now we can do this. And I'll just put another piece of carpet down on the floor here. That's a shame to see them. Well, game. There we go. It's a shame to have to change that around like that, but I guess if it's the only way you can do it. Like I said, in the residential setting, it works perfectly fine. It doesn't have an effect on it, but you know, due to the nature of the apartment zoning, yeah, it just don't work. So let's go upstairs and see what I can do up here. Is there going to be? Yeah. See, I got things I gotta get rid of up here. I'm just going to take this all down. I think I might be able to get away with putting a... let's see. Can I get... I'll open the floor up here. What did I just... Oh, yeah. Trying to get control of a new mouse. Yeah. I just... What? Can't delete? Why? Probably a light downstairs. I don't know. Whatever. Let's... go into the stairway thing and put an indoor staircase in here. And we'll just put, I'll use that one. Good enough. Turn it around. And we don't have enough bloody room for it. Okay, this is going to require a bit more engineering than I thought. So let me put this into a fast forward mode as I go through this and redesign a little bit, and then we'll come back and give it a try. Well, there it is. It ain't really exactly the way I wanted it to be, but I think it's going to work. I hope. We've still got two bedrooms upstairs. We've got a lot of windows in this room. I don't know if I'm put more. It's definitely different. Let's. I think what I'm going to do is go ahead and change this back to an apartment base, exit out of it, and then I'm going to move a test family in there and see if it actually works that way. So. Control Shift C. Change lot zoning, all one word, space. Then we go to APARTMENTBASE. Change lot zoning, space, apartment base. And when I hit enter, it should take. There we go. Now, again, it's not going to change until I actually exit this and come back into it. But once I do that, I will have a family, and we'll try to, we'll see if it works. Okay, guys, well, I took up the Gavigan family. This is just one that they had made up, and I'm just going to move them into this apartment here. Just go ahead and rent that for now, and then we will try furnishing it, and see, yes, we do want to furnish that, or rent that. Okay, all these messages, we've seen them all 100 times before, so let's do this, and somebody's got 250 points of aspiration. Looks like they're having a lot of fun, so let's see what happens here. I believe that they can go in this apartment now, I think, maybe. Let's see, I've just dropped all the walls down, so. And he takes off running into there. Okay, now the biggest question is, as we all know, we can put anything we want downstairs, furniture-wise or anything like that. So, yeah, we can... oh, man, the machine is being very slow today for some reason. I don't know what happened there. All right, just... I want to put a... Yeah, we'll just put that one in there for now. And a television. Of course, chances are I'm not going to really do anything with this family anyway. I don't know why I'm taking the time to do all of this, but... Okay, there we go. Now the biggest question is, can we do anything upstairs? Let's see if this works or did I fail. All right, let's go back here. And this was going to be the master suite back in here, master bedroom, but it's actually become smaller now because of how I had to rearrange. You can see it was in the original plan. This was the original plan, and this was the smaller room, and this was the bigger one. So now it's the other way around. This one's a smaller or bigger room, and this one's the smaller one. So anyway, I'm babbling and talking about nonsense. So let's see. Is this going to work, or is it not going to work? What do you guys think? Can I place a bed up there? Yes. See, that was what it was. It was because of the stairway. That was the only reason that I couldn't do anything up in that area with... the original plan. So it looks like what I'm going to have to do is go through all these apartment buildings There's four apartments in each one of these, and I've got three of these buildings to go through. And I'm going to have to go through each one of those and redo them all similar to this one. So, as we can see, it did work. And, yeah, I've actually managed to fix one of my failures. So, thanks for watching, everybody. And I'm just going to jump out of this. And actually, you know what? I'm not even going to bother saving for now. There's really no need to. So, yeah, we're going to get back into the Let's Play action. I believe I'm going to go visit the Porter family a little bit later on. Let's see what those guys are up to. I haven't been there for weeks, literally. Been quite a time I had over the weekend with reposting videos and stuff. But anyway, we're back on track now with Rick 73 Test 1. Looks like they've cleared everything up on the account, and it's all good. As long as I don't put any music on, we'll be in good shape. So thanks for watching. We'll see you guys back in the Let's Plays on Rick 73 Test 1. NJP saying so long for now. Thanks for watching, everybody.